Hello, everyone. It's Mr. B. I am here to deliver a very poignant and I think important conversation that we need to have as a family, as a community, about something that I think hits home for us personally, but I'm sure you can relate as well. And it's just about levels of stress and support that you have from family when it comes through on times when you may feel that you need them and they don't tend to be there when you really think they should. This hits home for us, especially with everything that's going on, just because, you know, in life, we take a lot of things for granted and we need to really just sit back and take some time to focus on what's important. So we all know family is a structure and it's a group that we tend to lean on when things get tough, when things get hard. But also, we look for them to be supportive. We look for them to be the energy that we need to keep going. We look for them to be those people that we want to bounce ideas off of, or we can get some constructive criticism from, or even share best practices with and say, hey, you know what? My uncle, my aunt, my brother, my sister, they said something today to make me a better person. But oftentimes, we find that that doesn't always happen, you know? Sometimes family gets so busy and caught up in their own lives that they don't even seem to have time for other family members. Or if we do talk to our family members, it's not even actually talking. We're going to social media pages and handles and different places to communicate when instead of picking up the phone and just saying how we're doing or seeing how you're doing. So I wanted to just address that briefly. As you guys know, I am Mr. B. I am Brian. I am April's husband. And I am definitely here to try to keep the channel going, to make everybody understand that the commitment to giving common sense and breaking bread with you guys is still at the forefront, even though right now she's having her time to get everything that she needs to get in order. I'm here to keep things going and keep that ship afloat. So bear with me, because this is my first time really doing it solo. And here we go. So what I want to talk about is a couple situations that have hit personally with me when I think about family and just the overall power of what family can do, and just some areas that I feel like I've addressed or that we've seen. And maybe, like I said, you can relate to it. And if you have any comments that you want to put in the comment section, that's fine. But I think it's a conversation that needs to be had, because oftentimes we assume that all family loves family and that all family supports family. But in the real world, that's not always the case. Seems like a lot of people have their own agendas and their own motives when it comes to things in family. Case in point, have you ever had that situation where you have a family member who knows your area of expertise? So let's say your whole life you've been a teacher and you have family members who tend to lean to friends and coworkers and other people to get advice on things that you know that you being a teacher, you being a person that teaches young minds, you have a great viewpoint on that, but they don't listen to what you have to say. They'll listen to some random person who has no background, no substance, no authority in speaking on that topic, and they run with those people's thoughts. And then when the ball blows up in their face and they realize that that person gave them bad advice, who do you think the first person they're gonna run to and say something to is you? Well, could you believe that this person told me? Well, yeah, I could believe it, because you passed on me, the person who knew a lot about that issue, about that topic, and you didn't want to hear what I had to say. And oftentimes we tend to not share things with family members because we feel like, oh, we already know what they're going to say, or we already feel like they're going to say the things that we don't want to hear. So in return, we don't share with them everything. And this really hits home for myself and April right now, just with what's going on in our house right now. We have our family member staying here with us. We love him to death. But there's times where there's things that he could share with us that he doesn't always share. So one day we asked him, we said, hey, how come you don't share with us like you should? Or what's the reason why you don't tell us when you're going through something? And he alluded along to the fact of that, well, I don't want to tell y'all because y'all always get mad, or y'all always going to try to tell me this or tell me that. And we keep on letting them know that, hey, we're here to support you, my man. We want to see the best things for you. So feel free to open up with us, because there's a wealth of knowledge with the experiences that we have seen in our past And even with the things that we're going through currently, we can always share best practices. We can always share something positive to try to help others. But oftentimes family members don't take that advice. They'll go to a perfect stranger and get that information. You know, April and I were sitting down, we were watching, you know, Jennifer Lewis and her documentary or her little segment that she had with Robin Roberts, talking about everything that happened when she went to Africa. Let's just unpack that for a second. She went to Africa, you know, a place where a lot of people love to go. She talked about viewing the migration of the herds of different elephants and lions and wildebeest and things just migrating across. She talked about going to the Serengeti and getting a chance to view things that some people may never see in a lifetime. Because her thing, like she said in her series that she spoke on, she talked about how travel was her thing. That's her love. That's her passion. And she loves to go out and experience different things. And then she shared with us, she was very candid and very open about her having her room and having all the great amenities and her falling tragically and getting injured. And she sat back there and she said to herself, she really thought that was going to be it for her. And a lot of people asked her, well, you know, well, how come you didn't tell your family, or how come your family wasn't, you know, notified as soon as it happened? And she made a comment that I felt that was pretty profound. She was like, well, what could my family actually do at that time? Only thing they could possibly do is try to get on a plane, try to come to where I am. But the best thing they could do is sit there and give me sympathy. And in her mind, she felt at that time, that's not what she needed. She didn't need sympathy. She needed to be empowered. She needed things that was going to help her get over her situation. So what did she do? She dug deep. She looked within and she said to herself, there's some things I got to do in order to recover. And what I got to do is I got to take care of me. And her taking care of me, it resulted in her saying, I got to step away from social media. I got to leave my presence of, you know, feeling like I got to serve the people for a moment in order to serve myself and be the best person I could be for those same people after. And she knew that as she was going through this, the patience and the ability that it took for her to step away from all those things that made her who she was, that celebrity personality, that voice, those comedic jokes, that dry humor that she had to step away from all that in order to heal. Not heal just her physical body, but her spiritual, her mental, her soul needed healing. Because that's a tremendous thing to be on your back and not know if you're going to make it out after surgery. Had a lot of thought processes that came in her mind that made her feel like, you know what, it's now or never for me. And she chose herself. And in choosing herself, she found that energy, that power, that will to go on. And now April shared with me a TikTok where she's doing TikToks with a walker. And then next thing you know, she's kicking the walker off and she's dancing because she found peace. She found strength. She found herself again. And sometimes we all have to do that. But when you sit back and you think of family as a whole and you put a lot of faith into family, they tend to let you down. And it's something that I've shared with April and I share with myself and I share with people that I meet when I see them. We put expectations on people that we shouldn't. Because the minute that you put a high expectation on someone, they're bound to not live up to those expectations. One, because they don't know what those expectations you are that you have for them are. And then two, they don't know what they don't know. So when you sit back and you say to yourself, oh, you know, my mom let me down. I thought she was going to do this. I thought she was going to do that. Why did you think that? Because that's how you would have handled the situation. No two people are alike. So you can't get mad at someone else for not being everything that you need them to be just because you try to be everything to others. So when you sit back and you look at the big picture and we talk about family, we just talk about the detachment of people and what you need to detach from to try to truly find yourself. I think at some point we all go through this moment. We all go through that time where we say to ourselves, wait a minute, let's slow down and truly evaluate what's going on right now. You know, am I being present for everyone, but am I being present for myself? Am I truly showing love for myself, or am I just out here showing love for everyone else? And it's an empty and lonely place when you find yourself trying to please everyone, but you don't seem to ever feel like you get that in return. So if there's nothing more that you get from this video that I'm trying to put up today, is love starts at home, right? No greater love is the love that you can have for yourself and for whatever you believe in. So if you truly love yourself, and if you truly want to be the best person that you could be for others, you got to work on you. My wife came here every day or every other day, coming on here, trying to deliver the daily caca, trying to deliver laughs, trying to deliver the common sense, trying to do the common sense on cooking, trying to do these different things to relate to everyone, to try to share her knowledge. And I can say, honestly, there's a lot of people who received it. We got a lot of different comments from people saying, oh, April, do what you got to do. We understand. We love you, girl. I'm going to miss you. You impacted my life in so many ways. But it's a lonely place when you do those type of things. And maybe you just want to hear that from someone in your direction saying, hey, you know what? This is what I see for you, April. This is what I need. Or what I think would matter, would make your life a little bit better. It's hard to be that person who people look up to and they hang on your words and they use your words in ways to better themselves. But then when you need that additional encouragement, you have no one to speak those words to you. And it comes across at times like, wow, am I truly in this alone? Because when those people need something, when they need an encouraging word, when they need that push, I'm there for them. But who's really here for me? And that's where that inner love and taking that time and praying to whatever it is that you believe in and getting yourself grounded and recentered and refocused and re-energized, that's where this comes in. And that's when you really need it. Because sometimes family's not going to be there for us. You know, it's sad to say, but in some cases, they look for us to fail. They think, oh, you'll never make that. Oh, you're too ambitious. You know, we just stay right here. This works for us. Kind of makes you think of Moana, if you ever watched it. Her father told her, we have everything we need on this island. Why would you try to voyage out? And little did we know, once you finish the whole story and the whole cartoon, is that they came from a family of voyagers. That was their thing. But because of one situation, he wanted to change the whole course of their futures. But then what you found out was the inevitable happened. She still got in touch with that side of her family and that rich history. And she still found that ability to go out there and be a voyager. So we can't lose sight of who we are on the inside. We can't lose sight of you know, what we're trying to do and what our focus and what our goals are. But I truly feel like this was just a little time that I felt like it needed to be said, because there are a lot of people who are also in the comment section thinking that it's more to this than what it is. And all it is my wife needing time to find herself again. Because sometimes we get lost in the sauce of social media and trying to please others. So please don't look into anything more into it than what it really is. And it's just simply some time for peace for her. Some time to get up in the morning and not have the pressures of, what am I going to say today? What am I going to do differently today? How can I impact someone's life today? You realize that if this is the only life we have to live, and we all know that, am I making the best of it on a daily basis? And I'm sure there's been mornings where she's woken up and say to herself, you know what? I could be doing something different. So I hope this receives everyone, you know, and hits home for you in some cases. I hopefully that, you know, something I said can kind of resonate with you when you say to yourself, you know what, if nothing more, this is a Sunday morning or a Monday morning or a Tuesday morning, whenever you're watching, and just say to yourself, you know what, I'm going to start loving me a little bit more, because I know when I put the best me forward, everyone else gets the best version of me that they could get. They're not going to get the watered down version. They're not going to get the version that I got to put forth, because really on the inside I'm hurting, but I can't let the world see. I can't show my vulnerability. Hopefully we realize that. And more videos to come, of course. But just know this: she loves you, I love you, we love you. We say these things and we take this time to talk because we truly feel like we can make an impact through the things that we've been through the knowledge that we could share with others. And that's why this channel is so unique. So if you're looking for everything gossip, everything salacious, we have those moments and we have that time where we feed that need. But we got to feed each other in a mental and a spiritual way on what we really need. And that's to see the best in all of us, the ability for all of us to do better. And the way how we get better is we have conversations like this, the difficult ones, the ones that are hard to have, the ones that show vulnerability. Because in your most vulnerable state, that's where growth happens. Because if everybody was good and everybody was just on top of it, you wouldn't see anything else you needed to do better. You wouldn't see an area of growth. But when you're truly looking on the inside and you feel that you're maybe not at your best, that's where the most can come from. That's where the most you could develop and grow. Because now you see the vulnerability and you see where you can do better and get better. So this is my time, guys. I thank you so much for watching. I tried to keep it short and sweet. I'm not as long-winded as my wife. But hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Stick with me. We'll have our next video coming up soon. Have a great day, guys. Peace.